So hash table is one of the most important data structures. We use the term hash function that maps a given value with a key to access the elements faster. A hash table is a data structure that stores some information, and information has basically two main components. One is the key and value. For example, the key value is John and the value is the phone number. So we pass the key value in the hash function. Hash key is equal to index. Hash John is equal to 3. So here John is added at index 3. So what is the drawback of hash function? Every hash function assigns each value with a unique key. Sometimes there exists a collision. The hash function generates the same key of two different values, then there exists a collision. So hashing is one of the searching techniques that uses a constant time. The time complexity is big O of 1. So we know the techniques for searching, linear search and binary search. In both the searching techniques, the searching depends on the number of elements. But we want the technique that takes a constant time. So hashing technique provides a searching constant time. So we use hash table and hash function. Using the hash function, we calculate the address at which the value can be stored. So look at this, index is equal to hash within brackets key. So key is the actual data to be stored, hash function, and you have hash values. So there are three ways of calculating the hash function: division method. We'll see a division method. So h of ki is equal to ki mod m. M is the size of the hash table. If the key value is 6 and the size of the hash table is 10, the key value is 6 and the size of the hash table is 10, so 6 mod 10 is equal to 6. The index is 6 at which the value is stored. We are calculating the index using the hash function. The value is 6 and the size of the hash table is 10, so 6 mod 10 is equal to 6. 6 is the index where you store the value. So what do you mean by collision? Two different values have the same value. Just take an earlier example. The value is stored at index 6, and if the key value is 26, so here the key value is 6 and the size of the hash table is 10, 6 mod 6 is 10, the index is 6, and here the key value is 26 and the size of the hash table is 10, 26 mod 10 is 6. So we have two values stored at the same index, 6 and 26, and this leads to the collision problem. So we use various techniques to avoid collision. One is open hashing, other one is closed hashing. So in open hashing, we use chaining method. So in open hashing, the keys are stored in linked list attached to the cells of a hash table. It is also known as separate chaining method. Each linked list is considered as a chain. So here we have a list of key values 3, 2, 9, 6, 11, 13, 7 and 12, and m is your 10, and we have a function h of k is equal to 2k plus 3. So we'll start with 3. The index of key value 3 is h of 3 is equal to, it's 2k plus 3 mod 10, and here it is 9. So the index is 9. The value 3 would be stored at index 9. Next is your 2, index 7, and next is 9, index 1. Next is 6, the index is 5, and next is 11, and the index is 5. So we have two values, 6 and 11. The index of key value 6 is 5, and the index of key value 11 is also 5. And this leads to collision problem. So we use chaining method to avoid collision. So we'll create one more list and add the value 11 to this list. And after the creation of new list, the newly created list will be linked to the list having the value 6, as 6 and 11 stored at the same index 5. Now we'll continue with 13, 13 index 9. So we have two values, 3 and 13, stored at the same index 9. So we'll create one more list and add 13 to this list. Next is 7. The value 7 would be stored at index 7. We have two values, 2 and 7, stored at the same index. So again we'll create one more list and add the value 7 to this list. And now it's 12. Index is 7. So check out, do we have any other element stored at 7? Yes, we have 2 exists at index 7. So we have to create a new list and add 12 to that list. So we have the various key locations. Three, two, nine, six, 11, 13, 7, and 12. So we have 9, 7, 1, 5, 5, 9, 7, 7. So whenever there is a collision occurs, you need to create a new list like this. And this example is different as which I explained earlier, just for a diagrammatic view I just given here. So whenever there is a collision occurs, you need to create a new list like this. Open hashing is also known as separate chaining. In closed hashing, all keys are stored in hash table itself without the use of linked list. Closed hashing, also known as open addressing. So we have three techniques: linear probing, quadratic probing, and double hashing technique. We'll start with linear probing. So we'll see some example here. We have the same example 3, 2, 9, 6, 11, 13, 7, 12, where m is 10 and h of k is equal to 2k plus 3. So as we already calculated the various indexes, so the key values 3, 2, 9, 6 are stored at indexes 9, 7, 1, 5. The index value of 11 is 5, which is already occupied by another key value 6. So when linear probing is applied, the nearest empty cell, the nearest empty cell to the index 5 is 6. The key value 6 is stored at index 5, and the key value for 11 index is 5, so which is already occupied by another key value 6. So in linear probing, we always search for the nearest empty cell to the index. The nearest empty cell to the index 5 is 6. So therefore, the value 11 will be added to index 6. The next key value is 13. The index is 9 when hash function is applied. 9 is already, the cell is already filled at index 9. And when linear probing is applied, the nearest empty cell to index 9 is 0. So 13 will be added at index 0. Similarly, for 7 and 12. So observe the key value 7, the index, and observe the key value 12 and the index. We always try for the nearest empty cell to the index where there exists a collision. So we'll just see another example. Here we have a table with size 5. Minus 1 indicates the index is available to insert in the table. At this point of time, we don't have any elements which are inserted here. So the size is 5 and you are inserting the data 13, and key is equal to data mod size. 13 mod 5 is 3, so 13 is inserted. Now insert 1, so 1 mod 5 is 1, so 1 is inserted. So we have 13 and 1 now. Now you want to insert 6, 6 mod 5 is 1. So there is a collision on index 1, because in index 1 we have already 1 and we have 6 now. Both are pointed to the same index. So to insert 6, we have a collision at position 1. So as per linear probing, you try for the nearest index which is available, the key plus I mod size, so it is 2. So 6 is inserted at index 2. So as 1 mod 5 is 1 and 6 mod 5 is also 1. So both 1 and 6 points to the same index. It's placed in index 2, the next available index. Now it's 11. 11 mod 5 is 1. So 11 cannot be inserted at index 1 as we have an element in that. So as per linear probing, the key plus I mod size, and it's 2, even at position index 2, we don't have place. Then key plus I mod size, that is 1 plus 2 mod 5 is 3. Even at position 3, I mean index 3 also, we cannot insert. So you move on to the next available index. The next available index is 4, and there 11 is inserted. So 1 mod 5, 1, 6 mod 5, 1, and 11 mod 5, 1. Now insert 10, 10 mod 5 is 0. So 10 is inserted at index 0. So in linear probing, the searching is performed linearly. Whenever the index is not available, we move to the nearest index. Whereas in quadratic probing, it's an open addressing technique that uses quadratic polynomial for searching until an empty slot is found. So it can also be defined as that it allows the insertion ki at first free location from u plus I square mod m, where I is equal to 0 to m minus 1. Quadratic probing uses quadratic polynomial for searching. The same example, the key values 3, 2, 9, 6 are stored at indexes 9, 7, 1, 5. So we do not need to apply any quadratic probing technique on these keys because there is no collision. For index value 11, the key value 11, the index is 5. The location is already occupied by 6. So we apply the quadratic probing technique. When I is equal to 0, index is equal to, and 5 plus 0 square mod 10 is 5. When I is 1, it is 6. So the location 6 is empty, the value 11 will be added at index 6. Next is 13. The index value comes out to be 9. Check out, do we have any other value there? If it is, then we apply the quadratic probing technique to calculate the free location. So when I is 0, it is 9. When I is 1, it is 0. The location 0 is empty, so 13 will be added at index 0. The next element 7, and we need to follow the same procedure. So I0 and I1, when I1 the index 8, so location 8 is empty, the value 7 will be added at index 8. And next element is 12, the index is 7, and check out, do we have any other element at 7? If so, then we apply quadratic probing technique on 12 to determine the free location. So when I is 0, index 7, I 1, index 8, I 2, index 1, I 3, index 6, I 4, index 3. The location 3 is empty, so the value 12 would be stored at index 3. So this is our final hash table. So what is double hashing? So double hashing, in this technique we use a secondary hash of the key. It uses one hash value as an index to move forward until the empty location is found. In linear probing, we search for the nearest empty location. In quadratic probing, we use a quadratic polynomial to find the empty location. And here, we use secondary hash of the key. So we use two hash functions. Suppose h1 of k is one of the hash function used to calculate the location, and h2 of k is another hash function, and you can define it as insert ki at the first free place from u plus v multiplied by I mod m, where I is from 0 to m minus 1. U is the location computed using the hash function, and v is equal to h2 of k mod m. So we have values, and m is 10, and h1 of k is 2k plus 3, and h2 of k is 3k plus 1. So check out for location 3, 2, 9 and 6. While inserting 3, 2, 9, 6, there is no collision, so we don't need any hashing technique to be applied. On inserting 11, the collision occurs. The index value of 11 is 5, which is already occupied by 6. So we will apply the double hashing techniques on 11. When the key value is 11, the value of v is 4. Now we substitute the values of u and v. When I0, I1 and I2, when I0 index 5, which is not free, I1 index 9, also not free, when I2 index 3, and the location 3 is empty, so 11 is added at index 3. And repeat the same for 13. The index is 9, which is already occupied by some other key. Substitute the values of u and v. When I is 0, the index is 9. So we'll get 9 value in all the iterations from 0 to m minus 1 as the value of v is 0. So we cannot insert 13 into a hash table. The next element is 7, and the index is 7, which is already occupied, and the value of v is 2. Substitute the values of u and v. So when I is 0, index 7, when I is 1, index 9, when I is 2, index 1, when I is 3, index 3, when I is 4, index 5. Check out whether the concerned indexes are free or not. If they are not free, we need to keep on moving. I6, I7 and I8. So we checked all the cases from 0 to 9 and we do not find any place for instant 7. So 7 cannot be inserted in the table. The next is 12 and the value of V is 7. So when I 0, when I 1, so when I 1 index is 4, the location 4 is empty, so 12 can be inserted at index 4. So here we have the final hash table.